We have a good friend of ours, Dennis Casey from Flogging Molly, in studio. Tickets still available at the Paramount box office.
So, Dennis, what's going on, man?
Not much, dude. We're in. I think last night we hit the halfway point on this long. This is an 8-week tour, and my voice is maybe representing that. ways to go, but yeah, we're on an 8-week tour. We hit the fourth week. I think it was the last night. I was out with a fan, and they had the tour shirt, and I was like, oh, my God, the left column is done. Bethlehem, Pennsylvania is at the bottom.
You know, we actually wanted to do something, and maybe if we have time, we'll joke and record it. We wanted to walk out and see if there's anybody there and how many people would or would not recognize you. And if they recognize you, we'd have a couple of T-shirts that we were going to give them.
That sounds like fun.
All right, so we could do that.
Flogging Molly is one of those bands, too. You guys have a big presence on stage, but off stage, you never got the most radio play. Never had the most merchandise. Why is it that you think your fans are so easily, they gravitate towards you guys so easily, even without the mainstream media push other bands were afforded?
I think it was since day one. It's the live performance. There's no replacement for that in any form of music and life. I think when a whole bunch of people get together and they're there for one thing, and this one thing is super energetic. Throw a little booze in there,
and not with you
and,
guys.
And it nah. just is. It's a great time. I mean, I'm in the middle of it, but I've from just talking to people, and it's a great, high energy, fun evening. So, and we toured our butts off. So we've been doing this 27, 28 years now.
Wow.
And, so a lot of people have come along. There's a lot of kids now in the front. It's crazy, dude. Mom and dad, and then the 12-year-olds, the 15-year-olds. It's awesome. It's like the new generation has come around. That's how old we are.
Well, that's kind of cool.
27 years. I mean, if you liked the band when you were like, you know, a teenager, and now 27 years later, got a family.
Like us.
We'll bring them.
Yeah.
That is crazy.
That kind of leads into the next question, because Orlando said that it's been 4 years tonight that Flogging Molly last played here. And then we did a lot of stuff together on Zoom talking to you. And I think we talked to you, I think, when you were doing, you were ready to do during COVID some sort of live stream. And
the Irish bar where they first played in Ireland.
And you were like, yeah, this is kind of weird, you know. So how has it been, you know, since post COVID getting back? The audience, like you said, they're bringing their family, so they're coming back and you're getting new people. Did you think that was going to happen? Because everybody didn't know what was happening when COVID happened. Like, did you think that all these people were going to come back?
Dude, the whole COVID thing, I didn't know what the hell was going to happen.
Yeah.
And then I, you know, that's the first, probably everybody else had the same thing. That's first phase. Second phase is, well, I think, when's this thing going to be over? And then, you know, and then you see the light at the end of the tunnel. And when we first started touring again, I was like, there was a lot more masks and a lot mm-hmm. people were, you could tell people were a little
hesitant.
Yeah. But now it's just like the old days.
Oh, good.
Thanks. Like the old days.
Yeah.
We have a good friend of ours, Dennis Casey from Flogging Molly, in studio. Tickets still available at the Paramount box office. Dennis, you mentioned it's now multi-generational. There's kids with their parents at the shows. Over the years, I mean, there has been Drunken Lullabies, Devil's Dance Floor, If I Ever Leave This World Alive, that are the more well-known songs. But do you ever look down? Is there one particular song where you are shocked that people are singing it word for word? That you're like, where did you hear that song from?
First of all, yeah, when you see the 15-year-old singing the lyrics to these songs, you're like, man. Yeah, like, how do you know all these lyrics? And Dave, you know, he's pretty poetic, so he's prolific as well. And, you know, there's a lot of word start songs. You're just like, man, this kid. Just gets down for it, and I think it's more like if we play Japan and you see some kid doing that, you're like, huh? This is like a whole different language. But I guess we'll see the younger kids when I see that. Like last night. Last night's a great example. So there's this brother and sister in the audience. They're I think I can't tell how old she is. She looks like 18, and he looks like 14. And I, you know, I jumped down. I always like to jump down after and shake it. She's showing me a picture, though, while I'm playing. She's like 12 years old. This girl's been watching the band for 7 years.
Oh, wow.
And now she's like this young woman bringing her younger brother to the show. And it was such a trip to see this picture of her I haven't changed a bit, of course. No, I'm kidding. No, she. I mean, she's just like came up to like my a foot below my chin, and then now she's almost as tall as me.
Oh wow!
It was pretty awesome. So, and she, I actually asked him the same question. I'm not just making this up. I swear to God, I asked her like, "How do you and your brother know like freaking words to these songs? Like they knew more than I did. I don't know all the words to this song because I'm not the singer, but they were like, "Well, we love the band, but to be honest, we prepped 2 days before the show. We were, you know, kids now, they can look on the internet, get the set list, you know, what we're going to do." And but it was really still remarkable to see that.
It's been, like Orlando said, 4 years since you played here tonight. And you played here numerous times here. And you used to frequent this place when you were around here. So what is so special about the Paramount for a band like Flogging Molly to come back after, you know, so many times?
Well, if you're a touring musician and you come to a place like this that has great people, great sound system, great stage, backstage is awesome, you get really well taken care of. Can I mention the other thing here?
Yeah.
Oh, they have a speakeasy or this special room that just blows everybody's mind. Like every guy, you know, like all bands are like, "Hey, we just played this place in New York. You ever been to that thing called the Speakeasy? What's the name of that venue?" I was like, "It's the Paramount, of course they know. I've been there many times."
And they also have another place now too, next door, Spotlight, which is
they do.
Yeah. Uh-huh. That's part of the venue. Yeah. So it's like their own bar. That's
great
over there.
Bar.
Yeah.
So
just
is
putting
that
it out there.
Pre-game or after game? Or both?
A little bit of both.
Yeah.
Okay. You know,
it might be a good spot for a 94.3 The Shark Flogging Molly acoustic thing one day. I'm just saying.
I would never know.
Because it's such a long tour, I did talk to Dave about this. He just got to save his voice. I mean, singing 90 minutes every night. You know, we're not spring chickens anymore.
You don't sing gently either. You don't play gently.
No, not at all. It's just full on, nonstop. And singers, I have a lot of empathy, like, because it's only these two tiny little things rubbing together. It's not like you go lift weights and like you'll be better at it. You got to really take care of it. So that's the acoustic stuff is harder to do.
Yeah,
I mean, for us, we can do it easy, but the same, you know, singing that. So
what about the tour length? When do you guys actually wrap up? Because I know the last album just came out last year. So is there any work on another album, or are you guys just basically touring Anthem right now?
Yeah, we're touring on Anthem. It ends on my birthday, actually, March 21st. Well, I'll be flying home on my birthday.
Freaky thing about your birthday, I just watched that show. It was based on the movie The Purge. I think The Purge was supposed to take place on March 21st, that movie.
Oh,
about
Spring Solace or whatever?
Yeah, like that, Solstice. That weird...
I gotta check that out.
It's not a movie, it's a horror movie. Basically, you never heard of it? It's like you're allowed to do whatever you want for 12 hours. Anything illegal, yeah.
Oh, I like
Ethan Hawke was in the first one. It's pretty cool.
I like
that. And that's on your birthday.
You know, Dennis, you talk about how... You know, you're not spring chickens anymore, but the truth is you guys have been bringing this music to people forever. You're the guitar player, but I know a lot of these songs mean a lot to you. We've spoken about it throughout the years. As you get older, as your kids get older and things change, does the meaning of any of the songs change for you? And do you change perspective playing certain songs every night?
Yeah, like we have, you know, one of our more popular songs, If I Ever Leave This World Alive, has been... on tombstones, it's been played at funerals. It's been, you know, it's almost guaranteed you're gonna see somebody crying in the audience, and then you're like, you'll start asking what the deal is, and they're like, they'll just say some really sad, horrible story. Like last night, same thing. I was with poor lady, her son had died, and I was like, oh my God, I can't even imagine burying a kid alone. But she came to the show because they used to like to come to the show. And. And that song just like it, it goes deeper and deeper every year, the older I get. And it's very simple, but it's poignant, and it just gets the depth of the meaning, just goes deeper and deeper the older we get. Because sadly, like, yeah, there's the people passing away, people getting sick, et cetera. I'm not trying to bring the Shark radio show down, but the only answer I give that song is...
But your music's always there to help them.
That is what this lady was telling me all about. So I know you're involved in this. Her son committed suicide. So okay. I felt it important to do something special for her. So I got like guitar picks from all band members. I got everybody signed the set list. And, you know, I was hugging her, and I was telling her, like, you know, now, what we can do now, or what we should do now, is celebrate your son's life. We can't go backwards. So every day, or I told her if she can every day, but like, whenever we're around, come see the band. We'll celebrate the times you had with him. That's all. It's kind of all we're left with when somebody leaves us.
And we are here celebrating tonight. There are some people out there listening right now. Hope everybody's. How many people are coming to see the show tonight? Oh, all right. Yep.
Everybody. Oh, wow. They're in line already.
They look like Flogging Molly fans.
They look like Flogging Molly. What songs are you guys looking forward to seeing? Crush. I'm looking forward to seeing Wanderlust, but I don't know if that's going to happen.
Rob, you're SOL. she's going to get what you want.
All right.
You've been asking for Wanderlust for about 10 years now.
Well, we're going to wrap things up here. You know, tonight, tickets are still available. You also have Skinny Lister and Anti-Flag playing. And what time do you guys go on?
9:30. Skinny Lister's on at 7:30, so I think doors are at 6:30.
You know, Dennis, at the Asbury Park show, you got me a little sauced. It was my birthday. I learned my lesson. I took off tomorrow.
And I can go in late. So, yeah.
So we're going out tonight.
Yeah, sure.
New York's got 4 o'clock bars, too.
You know, I don't know. Do they still do that? I mean, everything changed since COVID. So I haven't been out since 4 o'clock in a long time.
That's something that's been driving us crazy.
Oh, yeah, you're good? All right, so he says we're good.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
I don't know if it's 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock anymore.
So many places closed now that you're used to that have
the diners that were 24 hours, they're closed.
I hate
that. Dunkin' Donuts closed.
We happen to know a guy that might be able to keep things open for us. I'm just saying.
Well, I will take you out until 4 o'clock.
we have a late bus call, so.
Nice.
All right, well, Flogging Molly, they're here tonight. Dennis, thank you so much, my friend.
So good to see you, brother.
I'd like to thank you guys. It doesn't get old from the bottom of my heart, from the band, me. This means the world in this day and age.
Well, you know what? We played a bunch of Flogging Molly last night. I know you did. I did for the show. Yep. Played it all week. And, you know, if you want to give us any cut, just let us know.
You got it, Rob.